All right, welcome back to Recruit Pursuit Podcast. I'm your co-host, Devin.
Other co-host here, Evan Wiederspoon. Thanks for having me.
Yes, and we are joined today by Boston Walker, 2025 guard from La Center High School. Or forward, guard forward? You tell me.
Yeah, guard forward.
Okay, there we go. Mm-hmm. Guard forward. How you doing?
I'm good. Doing well. How are y'all?
Good, good.
Definitely good.
Yeah, I appreciate you coming on to talk to us. So my first question is, you know, let's just go back to last year. How was your freshman year? Just overall for you.
But overall, freshman year, you know, we had some setbacks, but you know, it's good playing for my hometown team. You know, it might be a small town, but it went well. You know, we had a couple of losses. You know, we should have won, but I think everybody has that. Of course, the stuff that we can improve on. Overall, it went pretty well as a team. As a player, I got to be more of a leader.
How are you going to be more of a leader?
I think being more of a leader, I got to talk more, push this harder in practice. That's really what it comes down to. You know, last year we didn't really have we had a couple of seniors, but nobody really wanted to lead the team. So I think next year I gotta make us work harder. You know, nobody really has that work ethic. Nobody wants to get better. So I think I gotta show that, not only verbally, but with my skills as well.
For someone who doesn't know your game, how would you describe that? For someone who doesn't watch.
I'm versatile. I can score at all three levels. I'm going to make the right decision. I can use my length on defense to get steals, get in the passing lanes, block shots. I'm athletic. I can use both hands. I'm good at finishing at the rim, and I'm physical, and I'm bigger. So, you know, sometimes I can get in the way of stuff. I can guard players 1 through 5, and it's just stuff like that. People want to sag off me. I can shoot the three, but when I'm going to the rim, people help. I can, you know, dish it out, get my teammates open. So,
yeah, from watching, I mean, I obviously haven't watched you live, but I've watched some highlights and things like that, and talked to other coaches, and I think that your game is very, you know, I think there's another step you could take. Do you know what I mean? You've showed great things on the court, but I really do believe that you're going to be one of those top guys in the entire state, no matter what class, maybe even halfway through this year, because I think you're going to take a big jump. What are some things that you want to improve on in your game for next year?
Of course, I want to improve. You know, I really want to get better, you know, shooting the ball, so I don't have to rely on just going to the rim, but bullying my way to the rim. I think stopping and popping for my mid-range shot, finding my spots a little bit better. My hands being equal, you know, my right hand being as good as my left hand being as good as my right hand. I think all that stuff will help me. My IQ for sure. You know, I want to have a high level IQ playing at whatever level so I can, you know, find spots. So I think those are some stuff I need to work on. So,
So I guess kind of give us a picture of your area. You know, you're down there in the southern part of Washington. I guess kind of what's it like playing in this small town league, I guess, and the community around that as well.
What's it like playing in where? Like my league?
Oh yeah, your league, and then I guess your town as well. You said it was a smaller town. What's kind of that like?
I'll say, you know, where I'm from is it's a little bit smaller. It's like right up from Vancouver. So, you know, there's some schools that have bigger, larger kids. You know, some people are in the middle of nowhere. They got, you know, just prodigies. It's definitely different. It's definitely different. You know, we're a different style of basketball. A lot of our players, there's a lot of skilled players that you would never know coming out from, you know, middle of nowhere. So it's definitely different. You know, my area, there's not a lot of people. You know, I play at a one-day school, so, you know, we got to make things work. we gotta play a different style of basketball. You know, it's very different.
What are some who are some players like within your conference? I think the Trico 1A, right?
Yeah, Trico, yeah.
Yeah, what are some players within the conference that you enjoy going up against?
If you know, you were at the Kingsway game, Giovanni Evanson, you know, 6'6", lengthy, 6'6", lengthy guard, can shoot the three very well. Super, super shifty, great ball handler. You know, he can find his teammates well, and their defense, Kingsway, that's a school tough player. You know, he's really tough, really tough. That guy for sure. That's pretty much about, that's the one guy that says to me a lot, Giovanni Evanson, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What's you been up to in the spring as far as basketball goes after your high school season ended? I know you were playing with Rose City Rebels. What was that experience like? And what else did you do?
My first, so last year I started playing with Rose City, the eighth grader. You know, we had made hoops just getting ready for preparing for EYBL, learning their sets and all that. So the competition is amazing. You can't ask for better competition playing at EYBL. You know, playing against the best players in my class, regardless of states or any of that. It's great, you know, taking my talent and playing in Orlando in front of all these college coaches. It's a blessing to play against all these great players, top 25 players in my class. You know, they're all five stars. So really playing against them makes me better against people I play against, you know, around my hometown. So it's been tough playing against them. So, yeah.
Oh, sorry to interrupt you there, bro. But I guess what's the most challenging thing about, you know, going up, you know, it makes you better. But what's the most challenging thing about going up against top tier competition, yeah, like, you know, of that caliber?
I think the speed of the game. You know, those guys at that level, they play so fast. They're really athletic and they can do everything. They can shoot. They can, you know, drive the ball. They're just all around players. Some of them are taller and lengthier. You know, I might be big playing against, you know, people in my league, but you go down playing against other people. There's people that are bigger than you, stronger than you. So it's really just your mindset that really counts for everything. You got to come in there and be a dog. That's all that really matters.
Who are some players on Rose City with you? I know we might not know them. I know some of them might be in Oregon as well, but you might know some kids. Yes. So
we're going to start off. We got our guard, Jalen Atkins, shout out to him. He's super tough, one of the best players in the class. We got Winners Grady, Dallas Washington, JJ Mandiquit, Cyrus Hutchison, and Isaac Carr, Nate Bunn. So it's a killer group of guys. Killer group of guys.
What's it like practicing around them compared to, you know, say your team, your high school team, things like that? And what's one thing that you take away most from the coaching at Rose City?
One thing that's different for the Rose City guys, you know, every single one of them, they're all the best players at their high school. They're all the best players around their area. So every single one of us, it's a competition. It's a dogfight every single time we come on the court. So, and it's leadership. You know, all these guys are very smart basketball players. So I learned a lot from them. And it's great competition to be playing around high level guys like that all the time. And it's very different from the center because, you know, I'm the best guy there. I'm supposed to lead my team. So when you go to somewhere else where you're practicing with a group where you have got a lot of guys that are as good as you or better than you, it's a really different environment. And the coaching is top tier. You know, we wake up 5 a.m, workouts. You know, the IQ training, you know, we watch basketball. We live basketball at Rose City Rebels. If I'm wrong, you know, you got to run a bunch of lines. It's definitely amazing. You know, they have all those connections. You get to talk to NBA players and stuff like that. Like, it's great. It's great. I love Rose City Rebels.
You meet any NBA players through them?
Some guys, like, They had a team back in, like, I think 2010 through 2012. I think like 10 of them, every single one of them went Division I. And so a couple guys come to work out. Mm-hmm. Forgot the name, but some dude, he's huge. I forgot his name. And they got, you know, Mike James, stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Mike James was that's crazy. I didn't know that. That's a good player.
he's got late bloomer, but he's really good. He's really, really good.
Have you played any summer league with Le Center at all this year?
Yeah, of course. I played we did a lot of games. We have like every single Tuesday we play at Lower Columbia College against some other schools. You know, we play against like 3A, 4A, 2A schools, you know, since the summer league.
How's that been for you guys?
It's actually been pretty good, you know, but I think our problem is, you know, we go up by 20, 30, and then since the summer league, we gotta let everybody play.
Yeah, yeah.
And so it's really just a learning experience, but you know, we're doing pretty good when we have our main dudes in, we're running our sets correctly. And for a team that hasn't played since, you know, December, since actual basketball season, I think we have a really good chance of doing something next year, you know, going to state and being successful. But summer leagues is going pretty well right now, you know.
That's good to hear. And yeah, like you said, everyone's got to play. So, I mean, it's not wins and losses don't matter in the summer here, you know, so as long as you guys are getting the job done and doing what you need to do.
Yeah, of course.
What's some players, NBA players you like to watch or follow your game after?
A couple of NBA players I try to model my game after. It's just players with good, like LeBron. I like how he's so versatile. He's a stronger player. I like how he finds his teammates. You know, I think he's a great player to look up to always. You know, Draymond Green, a very, very, very well, very good team player. He does everything on the court to help his team win. I think that's a good player to look up to. And Kobe Bryant, you know, watching him when I was growing up, his mentality is just where you want to be at. So, yeah.
You got a favorite team at all, or anyone you were, I guess, maybe rooting for to win it this year?
Man, I wanted any team LeBron's on, man. Any team LeBron's on. I'm trying to make them win. I want them to win. So I wanted them to win so bad, but, you know, stuff happens.
You think they can make it a better season next year? Kind of make it to the playoffs again?
I don't want to say yes, but, like, no.
Go either. It could go either way.
Why not?
I mean, when you put it on paper, the team is great. But, you know, with injuries and money and all that, some of the players want to act hurt. Some of them didn't want to play. Nah. They're a fun team to watch when everybody's there. But, you know, AD being hurt, like, nah.
You think Westbrook's the right fit there along with LeBron? Like, do you know what I mean? Is he the right point guard?
No.
Okay, no. Good. Yeah, me either. I don't think so.
They need a guy that can shoot off the ball. Like a Steph Curry, like somebody like that. Like maybe his brother, even Steph would help him out because LeBron is a facilitator. He's going to find teammates. So if he can get some pick and roll action, pick and pop action, you know, get some stuff moving off the ball, he can have a lot of shit. He needs shooters around him. He doesn't need Russell Westbrook, a guy that can only score with the ball in his hands on his team. Yes,
exactly.
That's a good point, man. Even Seth Curry would be insane with LeBron.
That's what I'm
saying. He gets so many threes.
It'd be nice. Yeah, like, I agree.
Westbrook can't shoot either. I'm sorry, Russell.
No.
It was rough.
Yeah, were you surprised that the Warriors won?
Yes, I don't like Steph Curry. Well, like he's one of those players like you love but hate him. You know,
it's just because everything goes in.
Yeah, that it's like he shoots it like please don't go in. He just makes it. It's like damn. And they're one of those teams. Like it's how can they not win? They play such. They just play very good fundamental basketball. You know, they set a lot of screens for each other, get each other open. They have a lot of guys that can hit shots. Even Andrew Wiggins, he was coming in clutch for them on defense. And Game 6, Klay Thompson, you know, they're just different. They don't miss. They don't miss. They've been running the same sets. There's only so much you can do against the Warriors. So
yeah,
it gets tiring, I guess. You have to, you know, following Steph through screens and so how many screens they set really it takes it out of the other team who's trying to guard him. And then when he still makes it, it's like, you know, what can you do?
Yeah.
there's really only so much you can do against that type of team. and they just play as they're like, they know what to do against any type of team. They've been there over and over and over again. And the Celtics, they're a young team. None of them has really been there. Jason Tatum, of course, is going to fold. Every young player folds when they're in that type of stage. So
turnovers are bad, though. There's a lot of turnovers, though, by JT.
It was a little
sloppy.
It was sloppy, but hopefully he can get in that. He's been there. He's never been there, but.
Yeah, you're right. He's young, too.
Yeah. And, you know, I mean, when you look at the, I guess, who he had to go against to, make it there, he had to go. He had to beat KD, and then he had to beat Giannis, and then you had to beat Jimmy Butler.
Yes.
It was tough, even though the Nets weren't that good. But
the Nets played the Bucks, right? And then isn't that what KD hit that long two?
Oh, last year.
Yeah. Last year. Okay. I thought that was pretty crazy. Just his foot being too tall or too big. You know what I mean?
I'm just surprised the Celtics got past the Giannis and the Bucks. Even with Chris being hurt, because Giannis is literally unguardable.
He is. And just wait till he gets that 3-point shot, because he's only 27, 28. It's going to happen.
Yeah.
And he's going to be insane.
Yeah.
What are some early predictions for you for next year? Who do you think is going to win it?
If I'm being honest, I think the Warriors might slow down. Trades are going to happen. I think Memphis will have a good chance. They have John Morant and Desmond Bane in them. So
they're young.
If they make a couple trades and they get a veteran on the team, push them in practice and stuff, then I think they can be a potential contender. I think if Chris Middleton or a different guy that can shoot the ball comes back healthy on the Bucks, then they'll have a chance to win it. For me, Miami, I don't see Miami having a chance to win, if I'm being honest.
Evan, isn't that your team?
I wanted them this year. Okay. I like how scrappy they played. You know?
Yeah.
Kyle Lowry.
I don't like Kyle Lowry, I'm gonna be honest with you.
I'm not gonna say I'm a fan of him, but I think he was part of the reason they didn't make it.
Jimmy Boston, Bell. You have any questions for us?
When'd you guys start doing this? Like,
gosh, four, this five, is five. Our, yeah, but we haven't been really consistently uploading. You know, this is probably, I think this is our ninth one, and I think our first one was back in March, beginning of March.
What motivates you guys to like do this? Like, what made you want to interview these, you know, potential young stars?
You can grab first, son.
Yeah, I think that mostly it's just fun to, you know, watch you guys grow. You know what I mean, and watch you guys game grow and individually yourselves grow, and you know, like. Like we've said in other episodes, it's fun to uncover the hidden talent, you know what I mean? And find those guys like yourself from the small schools and, you know, get their name out there and try to, you know, get you guys more exposure and more just attention from colleges and anything like that.
And I guess to kind of tag on to that, you know, it's when we started it, we realized that, you know, there isn't that many people like us who do this for, you know, high school student athletes, especially in the state of Washington.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, it's been tough the last couple of years, obviously, with, you know, the pandemic 2.5 years ago. And, you know, I mean, a lot of kids have just, you know, not been able to play or this and that, you know, the landscape has changed. So, you know, and, you know, we're from here and we like talking basketball, you know,
sure.
Just like you guys like playing.
For sure. We like watching you.
Yeah. That's great.
Evan, you have any questions, or Boston, any other ones?
I guess I don't tell, tell us, I guess outside of basketball, what do you like to do?
Mm-hmm. Well, from a little country town, you know, I like listen to country music with my boys, riding dirt bikes.
Yep.
Like stuff like that. Going golfing with the boys. I'm just stuff like that. I like going to barbecues with the boys. You know,
just hanging football. Out.
Yeah, lifting weights.
Yeah.
It's fun. It's fun out here. It's a little small town, but we have a little group. I've been growing up with them since I was really young. You know, I love my Lacena dudes.
There must be a lot of golf parks out there, like golf courses out there.
There is. There's a couple in, you know, Richfield, Vancouver. There's a lot of stuff.
So you guys go golfing a lot?
Probably go golfing like once, 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
What's your best round? You know what I mean? Score, I guess.
It's called. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not good at golf. I just go there. I'm not good at golf, I'm not gonna lie. I just sit there with my boys watching the boys. It's crazy.
It's still fun though.
It's fun. It's fun. I'm not gonna lie. It's fun. I get smoked though. I got my big dude Ryan Kowalik, my left tackle from the center. He might be he only 6'3", 300 pounds, but boy, he's good at golf. I'm not gonna lie, he's good at golf. shout out to
That's fun. That's awesome. You guys like golfing. What are what's your favorite sport outside basketball? I guess to play and watch.
Football for sure. Football for sure.
Who's your favorite team? The Seahawks, or do you like someone else?
I like. Well, my family's originally from Kansas, so I've always, you know, my dad, you know, them. They always talked Kansas with me, so I've always loved the Chiefs.
Yeah.
I'm not like a bandwagon or anything. Like I've been a Chiefs fan even when they sucked, you know. Yeah. I've always liked the Chiefs, and now that they're good, you know, it's even better. So, mm-hmm. I've always loved the Chiefs.
Patty is just crazy. I don't understand him.
He's different. He'll make any receiver look good.
People said about Tyreek.
Huh?
You said about Tyreek.
Tyreek, even though he left, it's not really pretty much. You know, he's hit the quarterback down in Miami. He's nowhere near as good as, you know, Patty Mahomes. And yeah. Patty Mahomes can make any look good, no matter who you are. He's going to put the ball right where you need it. So It's fine that he left. We got Travis Kelce and the rest of the guys. So
I'm not Juju. Juju Smith-Schuster. Yeah, that's right. That's actually not bad. Mecole Hardman. I heard that Tyreek was like, trying to talk about Tua, saying he's like Patty or something like that. I'm like, oh my gosh, come on.
Nope.
Come on. You got to be realistic. Like, even when he was saying that stuff, everyone was just like, all right. Like, why not? Like, you got to be realistic.
Yeah, exactly.
He's not going to be a still, no.
Sorry, you go. Yeah, actually, new question about how do you guys feel about the lefty quarterback? You know, because there's not many, and I think Tua is the only one, right?
I think so. I think.
Yeah. So, do you like the lefty quarterback, or?
I mean, I like him, but it don't matter what hand you are, you're still not gonna be better than Patrick Mahomes.
You're very right. You're very right. No one will be.
No, there. I don't think I've ever seen someone with the bullet passes, the sidearm throw.
So like casual.
The bullet. Yeah.
Yeah. Patty Mahomes is different.
He is different. Evan, you have anything else to add? Any other questions or Boston anymore?
I don't think I got anything else though. Too big.
I don't really got anything.
Yeah, I don't think I have anything else either. I'm excited to watch you guys play this year. I might not personally be able to watch a game, but I'm sure there'll be someone be able to go down there. And sure. Hopefully if you guys make state and we can watch that, keep me updated on everything and Evan as well. And hopefully we can have you on again for another interview, maybe halfway through the year.
Yeah, for sure. Just let me know.
Yeah, you got it. Thanks for joining us, Boston.
Yeah, appreciate you coming on. Good talking.
Thank you. It's a blessing, man. Thank you.